Joseph Smith, his father Joseph Sr., and his brother Hiram were actively involved in the occult while living in Palmyra, New York. Joseph Sr. considered his money digging an occupation and often brought Joseph Jr. with him on his expeditions. This involved special rituals and ceremonies which were performed for the purpose of obtaining buried treasure. It is through these expeditions that Joseph found his beloved seer stone, which he used to try to locate treasures of gold and silver. Joseph would place his magical rock into a hat and pull the hat up to his face to block out all light. By doing this, he claimed he could see supernaturally and would help those who were digging by locating the place where the treasure was buried and observing the spirits that were guarding it. Joseph and his father's money digging continued until at least March of 1826.
Another thing that was really interesting in studying the roots of Mormonism was to find out that Joseph Smith wore a Jupiter's talisman, and his brother Hiram had the family parchment, and they kept those on their bodies hidden. Another thing that most Mormons do not realize was that Brigham Young was cut from the same cloth. He wore a bloodstone around his neck as protection until the day he died.
One indication we have as an insight into Joseph Smith's character is the value he placed in a particular magic object called a Jupiter's talisman that he had had through his life. We aren't sure just when he first got it, but evidently as a teenager. But he kept it on his person until his death. And a Jupiter's talisman is a magic object that one would used to empower one with money, finances, power over people, power over women. All of these things were items Joseph's life was geared towards. He wanted power, he wanted money, and he wanted women. The fact that he died with the Jupiter talisman on his body shows that throughout his life he continued to hang on to that hope and that trust in that magic object.
We could then summarize it as follows. The old Babylonian religion gave rise to Kabbalism. Via the Essenes and others, Gnosticism came into existence, and Gnosticism was founded by Simon Magus. This comes from no other source than History of the Magi and by Eliphas Levi. Wow, that's a high Masonic source. So Gnosticism founded by Simon Magus. Then this Gnosticism, with its secret doctrine, was eventually, over time, through many intermediary organizations, carried over to the Knights Templars.
Thank you. Now, spiritism, mediumism, channeling, if you will, and necromancy, these things are expressly forbidden in Deuteronomy 18, 2 Chronicles 33, sorcery all through the place, Leviticus 19 and Hosea 4, Exodus 22, Isaiah 44, etc., etc., etc. So these are all elements of the occult. They're expressly prohibited in the scripture. And astrology also is expressly prohibited in the scripture. Let me remind you that to indulge in such a practice in ancient Israel was subject to death. These were not just little no-nos, slap your wrist. These were capital crimes. You get caught casting a horoscope and you had a date with the stoning. And the magic, of course, is prohibited. The Old and New Testament comes out. Divination is also expressly prohibited.